And Steve, no doubt, as you said, this war will also be fought in propaganda. You said you hadn't heard any missile strikes, any crashes or anything like that. Did you hear any ambulances rushing by? Because I know one of the reports said that they were taking these civilian casualties via ambulances to some hospitals.
No, no sounds of ambulances either, although Libyan officials are saying their hospitals are filling up with casualties. As far as the reaction from the government here, Colonel Gaddafi has not been seen in recent hours. He was supposed to appear before the press a short time ago at his compound, but he was a no-show there. We are hearing some anti-aircraft fire behind me. Certainly a very nervous city under threat, under possible attack. We've seen a lot of what we call panic fire. That may be an example of that as well. Colonel Gaddafi maintaining a very bellicose attitude towards these strikes, saying the U.S. will regret their actions. Those strikes, those Tomahawk strikes coming from U.S. ships as well as U.K. ships, and mainly targeting anti-aircraft positions to the east of Libya. Once again, we haven't heard the Tomahawks hit. We're right near his compound. What we are hearing is nervous anti-aircraft fire, people firing up into the night sky, and still an attitude really of defiance by the Gaddafi government, saying they will take revenge and the U.S. will regret these actions. As far as the situation on the ground in the city of Benghazi, a real tragedy there for some of the 700,000 people in that city. They have been bombarded through most of the day by Colonel Gaddafi's forces, government forces, using artillery on the ground as well as tanks firing into that city. Many of the civilians really trying to flee to the east away from Benghazi. Many also still trapped there. It's going to be a very difficult operation for this no-fly zone to operate because Gaddafi government forces are already within that major city. So getting them out, trying to protect the civilians, has become a lot more complicated in the past 24 hours. Heather, back to you.
Steve, it's Greg Jarrett. You're a veteran of many wars, and you're pretty adept at identifying the sights and sounds. Describe what it was that just occurred behind you moments ago.
You have a lot of lightly disciplined forces and a lot of people with small arms as well. So firing in the air is extremely common. Sometimes it's to celebrate, sometimes it's in anger. But we've also heard more than that today. We've heard heavier weapons, anti-aircraft fire, and that was a small anti-aircraft gun firing behind me probably about 200 yards away.
Steve Harrigan, streaming live from Tripoli, Libya. We'll check back with you as you see and hear more of what's happening there.